This is in continuation with our previous lecture on the white sheet, and now we will start surface charge and force on a conductor. In a charged conductor, charge resides on the surface. It is a well-known fact. As similar charges repel each other, therefore the charge on any part of the conductor repelled by the charge on rest of the surface. Now see this figure. This is an irregular shape conductor, right? And let ds, this is a very small surface, or you can say a small area. Ds, what is ds? Ds is a small area on the surface of a charged conductor. This conductor is charged. This conductor is charged. Sigma, when the charges reside on the surface, there is a term, surface charge density, denoted by sigma, defined as charge per unit area. So let's, sigma is surface charge density at P, which is just outside the conductor. This point P is very near to the surface ds, a small surface ds. Lekin chitr mein hum bahut dur dikhaye hain, lekin dimag mein sochna hai ki ya ekdam is surface ke jitna kareeb soch sakte hain utna kareeb hai, very near. And it is mentioned what surface charge density at P, which is just outside the conductor. The magnitude of the electric field at P, this is from the application of Gauss's theorem. So the magnitude of the electric field at P is E equal to sigma by epsilon naught. And what is its direction? Directed along the outward drawn normal to element. Now the physics is, electric intensity at P can be considered to be made up of two parts. This E is made up of two parts. Number one, electric intensity vector E1 at P due to charge on area ds. This electric field is due to charge on this area ds. And number two, electric intensity vector E2. Electric intensity vector E2, this vector E2 at P due to charge on on the rest of the surface of the conductor. This E2 is on the rest of the surface of the conductor ke chalte electric intensity E2 hai. Isn't right? Consider conductor. Now this vector E1 and vector E2 are at point P, are in the same direction. E1 is for the charge on this surface, E2 is charge due to rest part of the surface. Both have the same direction, therefore resultant electric field E will be E1 plus E2, and E equal to sigma by epsilon naught, so it is sigma by epsilon naught. Let it be equation number 1. Now consider the point Q, which is very near to the surface ds, and shown in this figure as point Q. This is also considered very near to this surface, but inside the conductor. At a point Q, just near the area ds and inside the conductor, electric intensity is again made up of two parts. What are those two parts? I will write now. Number one, electric intensity minus vector E1. Why? Because it is inward. At Q, due to charge on ds, because Q is very close to P but on opposite side of the surface, it is clear from the figure. And number two is electric intensity vector E2. These two are for point Q and these two are for point P. Number two is electric intensity vector E2 at Q due to charge on rest of the surface. Due to charge on rest of the surface. At point Q, see here, at point Q, vector E1 and vector E2 are in opposite directions. Thus, net electric intensity at Q is E2 minus E1. Why? Because these two are in opposite directions. But electric intensity inside a conductor is always zero. It is a well-known fact. Therefore, E2 minus E1 equal to zero or E2 equal to zero. So, equation 1 becomes, you can see the equation 1, it becomes 2E2 equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Or E2 is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. What it gives? It gives the outward force experienced by a unit positive charge on the element ds due to charge on remaining part of the surface, because electric intensity is equal to force per unit charge. So E2 sigma by 2 epsilon naught, again I am repeating, what it gives? It gives the outward force experienced by a unit positive charge on the element ds due to charge on remaining part of the surface. Now, what is the definition of sigma? Sigma is charge per unit area. For a small surface ds, sigma may be written as dq by ds, charge by area. Therefore, charge on area ds is dq equal to sigma into ds. So, force on area ds will be F equal to what? F equal to E2 dq. How? E2 is equal to F by dq. So, F equal to E2 dq. Put the value of dq from here. E2 sigma ds. Now, equation we have already written, E2 equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Put the value of E2 sigma by 2 epsilon naught. It becomes sigma square ds by 2 epsilon naught. Therefore, force per unit area of the surface will be what? It will become F by ds. So, take this ds here. So F by ds becomes sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Let it be equation number 2. Now, from equation 1, see the equation 1, sigma is equal to epsilon naught E. So, equation 2 is our outward force per unit area of the surface, which I have to determine today. It becomes, put the value of sigma epsilon naught E, it becomes epsilon naught E whole square 2 epsilon naught, 1 epsilon naught cancel out. So, it becomes 1 by 2 epsilon naught E square. This is our required expression for outward force per unit area of the surface. Now, in our next class, we will start capacitance chapter. Capacitance, parallel plate capacitor, then the chapter electrostatic energy of system of charges. जिस चैप्टर को लेकर चले थे वो चैप्टर पूरा समाप्त हो जाएगा. तो इन आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट कैपेसिटेंस एक्सेट्रा. थैंक यू वेरी मच.